We're going to talk about our song Graveyard Whistling.
Oh, we're on.
Yeah, Graveyard Whistling was, I'd say, was our kind of founding Nothing But Thieves track. It was one of the first tracks that we really figured ourselves out as artists.
Yeah, it started with the guitar riff, which kind of introduced slightly strange notes, didn't it?
We've always been obsessed with Radiohead since the beginning of our band, and it felt, that was a starting point for us, wasn't it, for this song?
Yeah, I think it was good as well, because it kind of experiments with your voice so much, from going in the low register into your falsetto, then into a cool blend into the chorus. And then I remember when we wrote the chorus, we didn't really know what it was. We were just like, is this good? Is this bad? What does it sound like?
It was cool. Lyrically, it was something that we really felt strongly about. We actually, it was something we have always discussed generally. It's I won't go into details, but it's about doubt and belief in atheism and believing in religion and stuff like that. And for us, that's something that we talk about daily.
Yeah, because we're really boring.
Yeah.
It's something that we can all kind of hone in on.
So yeah, no, that song came about, it took a while to actually finish it. I think it took about 3 or 4 days to get it all together, because we were kind of piecing it in bits, because we knew each sort of section was strong. And yeah, we finished it off, sat with it for a few weeks, and we're like, yeah, I think this is good. Sometimes you have to sort of let a song linger, don't you, to realise if it's actually any good.
It's still one of those tracks, I think, that everything we've ever written, I still listen back to it and think, I don't get it, which is a good thing. I think it's one of those tracks that I think it's almost someone else's track. I really like it. I think it's a...
Yeah, you can listen to it.
It's weird to explain, but I feel there's a little bit of magic within it that we still really haven't...
Yeah, it's released. It's definitely one of our most unique songs.
It's actually a weird song to play live. It's very...
Yeah, we had to change the arrangement live because it didn't quite work being so held back. We kind of needed to rock it up a bit, didn't we?
One of our team members, I won't say names, was like, oh, are you going to do an AC/DC version of it? And the track's ambient.
Yeah, but strangely, the concept of making it rockier actually did work a bit. Doesn't sound like AC/DC, unfortunately. No. We're working on it.